Good morning, everyone. Welcome to Pre-Market News and Views by In the Money Stocks. My name is Nick Santiago. Today is May 4th, 2015. Let's jump right into the charts here. We're going to start off with the S&P 500 E-mini futures. You're going to see that the futures are trading up by nearly 6 points per contract to right around the 2107.5 level. So we'll see if futures can continue to rally higher. They had a very, very good day on Friday. Anytime you close up on a Friday, that is a small positive just due to the fact that investors want to hold equities over the weekend. So that should be noted. But when we look at the markets last week, they were still pretty volatile. And again, volatility means opportunity. So let's take a look at some stocks in the news today. We have plenty of them out here. First one we're going to start off with is McDonald's. Ticker symbol is MCD. Looks like McDonald's is going to go through some type of restructuring. You could check out the news yourself, but anyway, slice it or dice it, the stock closed at $97.87. It is trading at $96.10. The only level I get interested in McDonald's today will be at $94.85. So keep that on the radar. Gets down to $94.85. That's where I think traders can step in for a scalp long play. Remember, a scalp is nothing more than a quick day trade that lasts between 10 minutes and 30 to 60 minutes. Okay, so again, it's not a long trade. It's not an all-day trade. It's just a quick scalp trade, and that is at $94.85. Let's take a look at Comcast. Ticker symbol is CMCSA. And this is a major cable company. Right here, stock is trading at $59.65. It closed at $58.41. We're going to give Comcast the upside today to around $60.60, $60.75, right around there. So there's still a chance for this to go higher. If you do own it, trail your stop loss going forward. That's really the best and only way to play it. Let's take a look at Cablevision. Ticker symbol is CVC. And stock right now is trading at around $20.49. Closed at $20.39. This is overbought on the daily chart, so you got to be a little bit careful with this. If you own it, I would trail the stop loss immediately. When I look at the bigger time frame, more notably the weekly and the monthly charts, I do see upside in the cards here to potentially $22. So again, you just want to trail your stop loss there, and hopefully that stock can move higher. Let's take a look now at Tyson Foods. Ticker symbol is TSN. Stock is trading at $40.30 at the moment. I really don't see a lot of upside here, but if the stock can give you a bullish pattern once the opening bell rings, then it could have upside a little bit later. But right now, very hard to see a lot of upside. There's still going to be a lot of resistance at 42.25 if the stock does trade up there. So keep that level on. I know that's a long way up, but right around 42.25, that's the big resistance level today for Tyson Foods. In the meantime, it is overbought, so be careful with this one. Try your stop loss if you own it. We'll be watching this right at 9 o'clock in the morning, and we'll be looking to trade Tyson today. Once again, if you have not come over and taken a free trial to the intraday stock chat room, come on and do that. You could trade right alongside of us. It's been an amazing, amazing month of May so far, and a great end of April. So again, 2015 has just been remarkable as far as trades go, and hopefully we're going to get a lot more going forward. All right, let's take a look here at our next one on our list, which is MGM. This is a casino operator out of Las Vegas, Macau. Stock is trading at $20.80, closed at $21.40. I am seeing some minor support right around $20.50. So again, watch for a little bit of support there. If that level does fail, you're going to have to look lower. But this is an equity that I will have some levels for, and we will be looking to play this in the intraday stock chat room today. Let's take a look next at Dow Chemical. Ticker symbol is DOW. Dow is trading at around $51.70. This is basically where it closed. I see very little upside in this equity. If it does start to rally, 52.25, 52.5 should be very good resistance. Be careful with this one. If you own it, trail the stop loss right now. Let's take a look at Cisco Systems. Looks like John Chambers is going to step down. Stock is trading around 29.02, closed at 29.13. Upside I see for this today would be around 29.59, 29.60. That would be about it. On the downside, If it does sell off, you could be a buyer around $26.60. So keep that on the radar today. Let's take a look at BroadSoft. BSFT is the ticker symbol. Stock is trading at $34.27. This is a pretty good move here. The only level that I'm seeing for this right now is around $38. So if it gets up there, again, that would be where I think you'd probably stall out or pull back. So again, BroadSoft, nice move up. That's a pretty good reaction to whatever news they had. But remember, this is a light volume stock. Rarely does this stock trade a million shares a day. Generally trades around 200,000 to 300,000. So anytime you get a lot of buyers or some institutional buyers, that'll push the market up a little bit more than you would normally see with the higher volume equity. So again, that's what we're looking at for BroadSoft today. Let's take a look at Cognizant. Ticker symbol is CTSH. This stock's also having a good reaction this morning, trading up at 62.85 at the moment. I'm going to give it the upside bias to $65. So if you own this, trail your stop loss. If you don't own it, it's hard to chase it up here. But nonetheless, this is a pretty good move, pretty strong move. Yeah, it's all-time high, believe it or not, is around 65, and that's where I'm getting that number. I believe it's 64, 69. So that's where I'm getting the 65 level from. It's just a major double top. But this looks pretty solid, pretty strong. So give it the upside to around that $64.75 to $65 level. All right, everyone, we're going to move over to gold now. Gold is having a good reaction today, up $7.60. Gold has been under some pressure recently. It's been a very choppy and tough trade. Right now, the GLD is trading at 113.54. Gold still remains very, very volatile, so you want to be a little bit on the guarded side with that. As far as light sweet crude goes, though, light sweet crude is trading up 41 cents to $59.56 a barrel. If you take a look at the USO, this has been fairly strong as of late. Today it's trading at 20.47, so again, it closed at 20.40. So you're getting a little bit of an uptick there. I don't see a blast-off move for oil, but nonetheless, keep an eye on the U.S. dollar today. The dollar is upticking ever so slightly, but as you can see, it has pulled back off its morning highs, and sure enough, crude oil has taken a little bit of a leadership role once that happens. So we'll keep this all on the radar. We'll cover all of this today, and we'll see how this all plays out. Another stock that I'm seeing that's making a little bit of a move is Zeus. I don't know if anybody remembers this name from a while back, but this is Olympic Steel, and this is a pretty good move from what I'm seeing here. Not a lot of volume behind it, but pretty solid little pop. So this could be something else that we keep on the radar once the opening bell rings in the intraday stock chat room. So with that being said, everybody, I want to wish you all a great trading day. Again, come on over, take a 7-day free trial to our intraday stock chat. You'll see everything that we're doing. You'll see all of our trades. You'll get every gap play, everything that we do each and every day. And we answer questions throughout. It's fully interactive. Most people that come in do not leave. So with that being said, I want to wish you all a great trading day, and we will see you on the charts.